Okay, welcome back to my class. So today we'll discuss a new chapter, and that is environment and sustainable development. So today we'll discuss what is the environment and what are the function of environment, or what are the significance of environment. So let us see this. We are knowing, we all are the human being, and human beings are also the part of environments and surrounding to us. So many things are there. Let us see. We can say animals are there, birds are there, then so many creatures are there, and sunlight is there, water is there, then air is there, and mountains are there, forests are there, trees are there. So everything which surround us is known as environment. So this definition, what is the environment? So everything which surround us is called the environment. There is another definition given in our NCERT book. Environment is defined as the total planetary inheritance and the totality of all resources. So total planetary inheritance, so total planetary inheritance, whatsoever the elements are living on this planet, Earth is a planet on this planet, these all constitute the environment. And totality of all resources, we can say this. Let us see the components of environment. So there are two components of the environment. One is called biotic. So there are two components. One is called biotic, another one is called abiotic. Biotic means all living elements, all living organism. All living organisms are called biotic. So all living organism, for example, let us see this, we can say human beings are there, human beings, animals, then we can say birds, fishes, then plants. So these human beings, we can say human beings, animals, birds, fishes, plants, trees, we can say these trees, this forest also, forest. So these everything, the all living organisms, so these are known as biotic. So environment include two things. One is called biotic, another one is called non-biotic, we can say, or abiotic. Abiotic elements, non-living elements. So non-living elements, let us see this non-living elements, so many non-living elements are there. For example, let us see this non-living elements, we can say rocks are there, non-living, this sunlight is there, sunlight, air is there, water is there, soil is there, so mountains are there, deserts are there, so etc. So many non-living elements are there. Non-living elements, rocks, sunlight, air, water, soil, mountain, desert, so many abiotic element, non-living elements are there. So we can say this environment. So environment, we can say environment is the combination of both living and non-living. So question arises, what is environment? So environment is the combination of both living and non-living things. Living things, I told you, these human beings, animals, birds, fishes, plants, trees, forests, these are the living things. And abiotic, non-living elements, rocks, sunlight, air, water, soil, mountains, deserts. So every environment is the combination of both living and non-living things. So these are the two elements, we can say, of the environment. Environment consists of two elements. One is biotic, another one is abiotic. One is living, another one is non-living things or non-living elements. Next one is the function of environment. Environment, let us see, we are knowing, is having the significance in our life, because it is, let us see, it is having significance, having importance in our life, in the field of production, in the field of consumption. So many functions are there. The first and most important function is there: environment supply resources. So environment supply resources. So different types of resources are being supplied by the environment. Environment used to provide different types of the resources. Resources, you are knowing, are classified into two categories. One is called renewable resources. Another one is called non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are the resources which can be generated. You take the example of fishes or the trees or the plants. Let us see, plants can be regenerated, trees can be regenerated, forests can be regenerated, fishes can be regenerated. So the resources which can be regenerated are known as renewable resources, whereas there are certain resources which cannot be regenerated. If it will be used, then certainly it can be exhausted, such as you take the example of fossil fuels, such as petroleum products. You take the example of iron ore. You take the example of this coal. So this type of petrol, diesel, iron ore, or this natural gas, these are the resources. If it will be used continuously, if it will be exploited continuously, then certainly they can be exhausted and they can finish. Certainly, let us see. So these resources cannot be regenerated. They can be generated after the millions of years. That takes long period of time for the regeneration of these resources. So here, environment supply both the resources, renewable and non-renewable resources, are supplied by the environment. So environment provide us different types of resources, and you are knowing resources are very, very important for the production. So we can produce the goods and services by utilizing different types of resources. You take the example of petrol. Without petrol nowadays, we cannot think of the production of goods and services. We cannot think of the transportation services. So this it means, let us see, these are the resources. So environment used to provide us renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Apart from this, let us see, environment assimilate waste. Assimilate means absorb. When, let us see, the goods are being produced, so in the process of production, different types of the this waste are generated. When the goods are produced, let us see, the industries, they used to release dirty waters, they used to release different types of the smoke and different types of the harmful gases, and that gases are absorbed by the environment, and the dirty water released by the industries, they used to go into the this water bodies, they go into the river or they go into the ocean, and they are being absorbed by it. Means environment used to absorb the waste which are being released by the industries in the process of production. Other side, let us see, when we consume the goods and services, we are also releasing different types of the wastage. Let us see, garbages are there. You take the example of your kitchen debris, or when you are going to the canteen and when you are enjoying the chips or different items, edible items, it is packed in the plastic packets. So certainly, let us see, we are releasing different types of the wastage, garbages, but that garbages are being absorbed by the environment. Environment itself used to absorb the garbages, used to absorb the wastage in the process of production and the process of consumption. So environment assimilate wastage. It means this is the second and most important function of the environment, is that it assimilates wastage. So production and consumption activities generate waste, which is absorbed by the environment. Absorbed by the environment. Environment used to absorb. Another function is environment sustain life. Let us see this. We cannot live on the other planets. Let us see. We cannot go on the Mars. We cannot start living because so many the elements which are available on the Earth are not available on that planets. Let us see this. Such as, let us see, sunlight is not there. Adequate amount of sunlight is not there. Water is not there. Air is not there. Soil is not there on other planets. It is there only on this Earth, and that is why it is very easy to sustain our life. So this environment provides us the different types of the elements which are essential for our survival. So let us see, environment sustains life. It sustains life by providing essential elements like sunlight, air, water, soil, etc. So these are the essential elements which are being provided by the environment. And these are very, very essential for our survival. And let us see, this environment used to provide this sunlight. Without sunlight, it's very, very difficult to survive. Without air, we cannot survive. Without water, we cannot survive. Without soil, we cannot produce any goods and services. And this these are the different elements are being provided by the environment, and this sustain our life. Another last and important function of the environment is given. Environment provides aesthetic services. So environment provides aesthetic services like scenery, let us see, which includes rivers, ocean, mountain, deserts. So let us see this different types of the sceneries are there. When we are looking outside, then we are enjoying the sceneries, the beauty of mountain, the beauty of desert, the beauty of trees, the beauty of river, the beauty of ocean. The people, they used to go on the they used to go to see the mountains, they used to go to see the rivers, they used to go to see different types of the this beauties of the trees and forest. And they used to enjoy, they used to see, let us see, different types of flowers give us the gives us the satisfaction. It gives us the happiness. Let us see, we used to get the happiness, and that happiness is very, very important for the life. So what happened? This environment provides aesthetic services, and these aesthetic services includes the different types of the sceneries. When we used to go and see the different types of the sceneries, it gives us pleasure, it gives us happiness, and that is also very, very important part of our life. You might have seen the tourists, they are going to the different tourist places in order to get the enjoyment, in order to get the happiness, because this sceneries, it gives us the happiness, it gives us the pleasure, and this is being provided by the environment. So let us see what we have learned. We have learned the meaning of environment. Everything which surrounds us is called the environment. And let us see the components of environment. We have seen biotic and abiotic. Everything is the environment is the combination of both living and non-living things. And function of environment, we have seen the environment supply resources, environment assimilate waste, and environment sustain life. Environment provides aesthetic services. I think the meaning and the function of the environment is clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.